World.
Well, Dima Kolchinsky joins us now from Kyiv with the latest. Thanks so much for speaking to us, Dima. I mean, in the immediate aftermath of this crash, we'll remember it looked like Kyiv agreed with Iranian assessments until it suddenly retracted some initial statements. So what's being said now in Ukraine about potential causes and the investigation going forward?
They are actually invested. The Ukrainian State Security Council has created a certain a certain committee, special committee, which is investigating. They so far have four reasons. Among those four reasons were the ones which were mentioned previously. But the one which is, seems to be the most kind of intriguing and at the same time controversial is the fact that on some of the social networks there were the pictures of the remains, which are the alleged remains of the Russian so-called TOR missile system. And that is also have been taken into account as the official version by the Ukrainian State Security Council.
Right. So it sounds like there could be some suspicion here. And with Iran saying it will not hand over the black boxes to either Boeing or U.S. investigators, where does that leave Ukraine?
Ukraine had already sent people to Iran, and presumably they will have the access, and it will be a better access than the one which had been there after the downing of the MH17 Boeing. But those are the same people who are from the Ukrainian side who have been investigating Boeing. They are the same ones who went to Iran.
You know, it's interesting. I mean, the speculation here must resonate particularly hard with Ukrainians, especially since the Malaysian Airlines passenger jet was shot down out of the sky by a missile over Ukrainian territory back in 2014. Is there much mention of that where you are?
There are some analogies which are, you know, you can already see in the on the social networks, and they are expressed by the opinion leaders, by the activists, by the politicians, but and it's analogy of basically a bad luck. But at the same time, there is some an attempt to explain it rationally, just putting ahead the Ukrainian vulnerability and putting ahead the fact that the Ukraine is in a sort of a front line of the basically. Big political and economical and civilizational warfare right now, and that's why it is vulnerable, and that's why things like that can happen.
Okay, Dima, we'll leave it there. Thank you for that from Kyiv. Still to come, we'll look at why the Duke and